Hello everyone, this is Gopi again from IT Guy. In this video, we are going to discuss about creating and running Flask applications. First thing, I'm going to import the Flask. From Flask, I'm going to import Flask class. Okay, for the variable app, I'm going to keep the instance of the class Flask. This Flask constructor require a special variable which is called as double_name. We are going to discuss about this variable in a minute. Before that, I will be completing the source code path. App.route. Here is how you will be registering the route for your application. Okay, so this route will support only the get. Okay, so here is the method. I'm going to give some method name. You could give whatever the method name you want. So I'm going to tell it as an index method. It will not accept any parameter, so it will just return a static content. Flask tutorial from Gopi. Okay, so now we are completed, and this is how we will tell the status code. This is called as 200. Okay, this represents the status code of success. Okay, so for each and every request, based on the response code only, we will consider whether the request has succeeded or failed. Okay, so by default, I am setting it the request response status code as 200, so that it is success. So I am going to check double_name equal to double_main. Why? Because by default, the value for the variable, special variable, double_name is double_main. Okay, when you try to import this file into another file, on that case, the value for the variable double_name is changed to the file name, okay, not the module name. Now I am going to tell the app.run. So that's all. I'm done with my coding part, and it's time to run the Flask application. The Flask application has been started. I'll move into my browser to send a request. Okay, I'm just sending a request, and the response would be Flask tutorial from Gopi IT Guy. Okay, so in the code, another important thing you need to understand is the file name. Here my file name is app.py, and here I am using Flask run command. Okay, to use the Flask run command, your file name should start with app.py file, or else your root directory must have a whiskey file. Let's check that. index.py. I have renamed my file. I'm going to restart my server with the same command. So you could see that error message from the framework, whiskey.py file or app.py file is not found. To use that command, you must have a file name app.py, or else whiskey.py should be there. If we have whiskey.py file, then we will be having this two line of code in the whiskey.py file. Okay. Another way of running the Flask application is Python under the file which you wanted to run. Okay. So now the server has started. I'm moving to my browser and refresh the. You are getting the same result. Okay, these are all the two ways to run the Flask application. One is using flask.run, another one is using Python file name. Thank you. That's all for this video, and we'll be catching up on the another one.